So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, you know what you have to do. If you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. All the information you will get here on this Telegram group. Alright, so let's begin with the very first question. The new DGFT's trade facilitation app is a step in the right direction as it provides easy omni-channel access to various trade related processes and inquiries at the touch of a button. The question is, this app has been developed by which organization? Kaun si organization ne is app ko develop kiya hai, which is known as DGFT's Trade Facilitation App. Now guys, this DGFT, Directorate General of Foreign Trade, works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry and it looks after all the laws. It administers all the laws which are responsible for the foreign trade and foreign investment. Alright, so DGFT ka kaam I hope aapko clear hai. And this new app, DGFT Trade Facilitation Mobile App, has been developed by Tata Consultancy Services. Alright, Tata Consultancy Services ne isko develop kiya hai as per the directions of DGFT. Alright, now what will this app do? This will promote ease of doing business and provide quick access to information to exporters or the importers anytime, anywhere. Har tarike ki export or import related information through this app can be accessed by the importers and the exporters, and it will definitely promote the ease of doing business. Alright, now what are the basic features of this app? Of course, ye sab aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. You don't have to remember all these features of the app. These are just for the basic understanding what this app will provide, like real-time trade policy updates and event notifications, trade dashboard anytime, anywhere, access all service offered by DGFT in the app, explore item by export import policy and statistics, 24/7 virtual assistance for trade-related queries, etc. So all these things will be provided by this app. All right. So now that's it about this news. Now let's come back to the question. Now you have to tell me who is the chairperson of Tata Group. Tata Group ke chairperson ka naam jaldi se comment mein likhke batao. So the question was, this app has been developed by which organization? So this has been developed by Tata Consultancy Service, option B. Tata Consultancy Services is the correct answer. Alright. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which is guys a very important question. It is about an initiative, or you can say a portal, or you can say an electronic platform. So the Minister for Commerce and Industry, who is Mr. Piyush Goyal, and he is also, we all know, the Minister of Railways. Alright, he is also the Minister of Railways, inaugurated eSanta, an electronic platform to connect aqua farmers and the buyers. Now the question is, what is the full form of eSanta? And eSanta stands for Electronic Solutions for Augmenting Dash Trade in Aquaculture. Okay, so you have to fill this dash. Okay. So now let's talk about this news first, then we'll again come back to the question. So the Union Commerce and Industry Minister, Mr. Piyush Goyal, has launched this electronic platform which is known as eSanta. Now what is the basic objective? The basic objective guys of this app, of this platform, is that it will connect the aqua farmers with the buyers and the exporters. Ye buyers ko aur jo exporters hain unko aqua farmers ke saath connect kar dega. So it will have the dual objective. Number one, it will enable the farmers to get a better price of their products, and number two, it will enable the exporters to directly purchase quality products from the farmers. Matlab yahan pe middleman ka jo role tha wo khatam ho jayega. Now the exporters or the buyers can directly buy their required products from the aqua farmers, and also the farmers will get a better price for their products. All right and now what is the full form of eSanta? Now let's come to the full form. It's electronic solution for augmenting NAKSA farmers trade in aquaculture. Now what is this NAKSA? NAKSA guys stands for National Conservation National Center for Sustainable Aqua Farming. Sustainable Aqua Farming is the full form of NAKSA, and the farmers which are associated with NAKSA will provide will get benefit through this electronic platform, of course. And NAKSA guys, basically it is an extension arm of MPDA. I hope aap sabne MPDA ka naam suna hoga. It is an extension of MPDA, and those farmers who are associated with aquaculture will get benefited through this initiative, through this electronic platform which is known as e-center. Now what will be the working process, kis tarike se kaam karega ye e-center electronic platform? So the farmers guys will list their produce and quote their price on this platform. Farmers kya karenge, apne producers ko, apne products ko list kar denge on this platform with the price. And the exporters will have the freedom to list their requirements. So exporters, what will exporters do? They will list their requirements. Wo unki requirements ko list karenge, and also they will have the freedom to choose the products based on their requirements, such as size, location, harvest dates, etc. So basically it will have dual benefits. Jo farmers hain wo apne producers ko list kar sakte hain with their prices, and the exporters will have the freedom to choose as per the requirements. All right. Now the platform guys will be available in many languages, which will help the local population. And of course it will act as a digital bridge between the farmers and the exporters or the buyers. And it will guys also provide a cashless, contactless and paperless electronic trade platform between the farmers and the exporters. Now there is an acronym which is known as RACE. So is RACE se aapse question pucha ja sakta hai exam mein, how e-Centa will raise the lives and incomes of farmers. So it will do it by reducing the risk, by increasing awareness of products in market, increase in income, shielding against wrong practices and ease of processes. So RACE ka full form aapko pata hona chahiye, that's important. And remember NACSA, as I told you, National Center for Sustainable Aquaculture is the full form, and it is an extension arm of the Marine Products Export Development Authority, which in short is MPDA. And MPDA guys also works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And remember, the basic objective of NACSA is to encourage and uplift the small and marginal farmers which are associated with the aquaculture. जो एक्वाकल्चर से एसोसिएटेड स्मॉल एंड मार्जिनल फार्मर्स हैं, उनकी लाइव्स और उनके इनकम, उनका जो लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड है उसको एनहांस करना, उनके इनकम को एनहांस करना इज द बेसिक ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ NACSA. एंड रिमेंबर NACSA इज एन एक्सटेंशन आर्म ऑफ MPDA विच वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. एंड रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ NACSA ऑल्सो, नेशनल सेंटर फॉर सस्टेनेबल एक्वाकल्चर. ऑलराइट. सो गाइज, दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. आई होप यू कैन इजिली आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन नाउ. Electronic solution for augmenting NACSA farmers trade in aquaculture, option B will be the correct answer here. All right. And now let's move ahead to question number 3. So again, there is one more news about Atal Innovation Mission. So Atal Innovation Mission, which is under the Niti Aayog and Embassy of Denmark to India, signed a statement of intent on 12th of April. The partnership would be executed through Innovation Center Denmark. So this partnership guys, remember, would be executed through Innovation Center Denmark. This is a very important information already given in the question. So what is the purpose or the purposes of this partnership? Kya purpose hai ya fir kya purposes hai is partnership ke? Let's discuss this news then. So a statement of intent was signed for the Innovation Center Denmark to collaborate with Atal Innovation Mission under the Niti Aayog to support various current and future initiatives of Atal Innovation Mission. Atal Innovation Mission ke करंट और फ्यूचर इनिशिएटिव्स को सपोर्ट करने के लिए दिस स्टेटमेंट ऑफ इंटेंट हैज बीन साइंड. एंड गाइस रिमेंबर, इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ इंडो डैनिश बायलैटरल ग्रीन स्ट्रेटजिक पार्टनरशिप. नाउ दिस ग्रीन स्ट्रेटजिक पार्टनरशिप गाइस इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर आवर एग्जाम. जस्ट रिमेंबर दैट दिस स्टेटमेंट ऑफ इंटेंट हैज बीन साइंड अंडर द इंडो डैनिश पार्टनरशिप विच इज नोन एज ग्रीन स्ट्रेटजिक पार्टनरशिप. ऑलराइट. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द पर्पस, सो व्हाट आर द पर्पसेस ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट ऑफ इंटेंट? सो to jointly work towards promoting innovation and entrepreneurship among the aspiring entrepreneurs, and to develop green economy partnership to address the SDG goals. All right, so iske do objective hai. Number 1, innovation or entrepreneurship ke towards kaam karna, and number 2 is to develop green economy partnership taki hum SDG goals ko achieve kar paye. And the partnership guys would be executed through Innovation Center Denmark, as I told you, as it was also given in the question. And it will help innovators to access Danish technical expertise and allow Danish innovators to work on India specific solutions. So basically इससे इंडिया के जो इनोवेशन एंड रिसर्च इकोसिस्टम है उसको काफी अच्छा बूस्ट मिलेगा, और जो भी हम डेनमार्क के रिसर्च और इनोवेशन बेसिस है उसका इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं. ऑलराइट. सो आई होप दिस न्यूज इज क्लियर, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. व्हाट इज द पर्पस और द पर्पसेस ऑफ दिस पार्टनरशिप? To support various current and future initiatives of Atal Innovation Mission, yes, and to develop global innovation green economy, addressing SDG goals. So both the statements are absolutely correct. Both are the purposes of this statement of intent. So option C, guys, here is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, guys, which is the last question for today. To provide single window access to the energy data for the country, India Energy Dashboards version 2.0 was launched by which organization? कौन सी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ने इंडिया एनर्जी डैशबोर्ड्स वर्जन 2.0 लॉन्च किया है? सो रिमेंबर गाइस, दिस इंडिया एनर्जी डैशबोर्ड वर्जन फर्स्ट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2017. पहला वर्जन कब लॉन्च हुआ था? 2017 में. नाउ व्हाट दिस डैशबोर्ड प्रोवाइड, क्या इससे हमें मिलता है? सो गाइज, इट प्रोवाइड्स एनर्जी रिलेटेड डेटा. जो भी हमारे देश में एनर्जी हार्नेस की जाती है, जो भी प्रोड्यूस की जाती है, कहाँ से प्रोड्यूस की जाती है, कौन से सोर्सेस से प्रोड्यूस की जाती है, सो ऑल द एनर्जी रिलेटेड डेटा इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय दिस इंडिया एनर्जी डैशबोर्ड. नाउ इट्स सेकंड वर्जन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड एंड रिमेंबर द फर्स्ट वर्जन वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2017 एंड द करेक्ट आंसर, लेट मी टेल यू, द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज नीति आयोग. द नीति आयोग हैज लॉन्च्ड द सेकंड वर्जन. ऑलराइट, सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, नीति आयोग हैज लॉन्च्ड इंडिया एनर्जी डैशबोर्ड वर्जन 2.0 एंड द फर्स्ट वर्जन वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2017. Now, this, the basic objective is to build a comprehensive, open and freely accessible India energy data portal for the country. Okay, and as I told you that India energy dashboards provide single window access to the energy data for the country. Now, talking about the second version, isme kya khas baat hongi? To khas baat to waise kuch nahi hongi, it's just a second version. So, the data will be provided by Central Electricity Authority, Coal Controller Organization. So, basically, all the organizations which are related to energy harness or the energy production will provide data to this portal, and in turn this portal will be accessed or can be accessed by the citizens of our country. All right, now this will provide time series data from financial year 2006 to financial year 2020. Financial year 2006 se leke financial year 2020 tak ka data will be provided through this second version, and the data will be provided from Saubhagya portal, Ujala, Prapti and Vidyut Prabha. So there are various portals which are related to electricity generation or the other sources or the other energy sources generation. So from all those sources, the data will be collected and will be accumulated on this single dashboard. And from here, all the energy related data can be accessed in future. All right. So this was about this news, and I already told you the answer. The correct answer is what? Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog has launched this second version. Alright. So guys, that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.